Hi everybody. I'm very glad to be back doing some art with you. And last week we looked at Sir Joseph Banks, and he was a local guy, wasn't he? He grew up in Lincolnshire, but actually this is hundreds and hundreds of years ago that we're talking about, when he lived and was alive and he was doing his botanical illustrations. So I thought I'd introduce you to another artist now, who's probably a more modern botanical artist. Her name was Margaret Mee. She was born in 1909 and she died in 1988. So it's still a while ago, but much more up to date than Sir Joseph Banks. He was hundreds of years ago. So let's have a look at Margaret Mee. Margaret Mee was a petite English lady and a botanical artist who produced hundreds of botanical paintings as a result of her exploration of the flora, that's the flowers, and the plants of Brazil, along the River Amazon and in the Amazon rainforest. She follows in the traditions of the great lady botanical artist explorers. I love when you look at the picture of her to think that she was actually a really brave explorer, not just an artist. And if you remember last time, we talked about how botanical art was as much about science, or more about science, than it was the actual art that was produced. So this is a clever scientific artist, and this clever lady, this brave lady who adventured off all around the Amazon. In 1952, when she was aged 42, not that much older than me, just a little bit, she left England to go and live in the Amazon. When she was 47, she started to explore the Amazon, where she studied and painted the plants and the flowers of the Amazon rainforest for the next 30 years. She also found and recorded new plants, which are now named after her. So imagine this lady, who at the age of 42 decided to just uproot her whole life and move to the Amazon rainforest. What an amazing adventure. For 30 years, Mrs. Mee devoted her life to travelling up the Amazon River and its various tributaries. That's all the little bits that came off the main river, just investigating and exploring. She would head upriver in a small boat by herself, with maybe a local pilot for company and for friendship. So she would get a local person who knew where the rivers went and knew where they were going, and he would join her on the boat and kind of be her pilot and help her know where she was going. Mrs. Mee was not simply a traveller or an explorer of new places. She was a painter who tried to create a unique record of some of the rare species of flowers of the Amazon basin before they disappeared under the onslaught of man. That means she discovered flowers that nobody had seen because nobody ever went there. And she recorded them before people discovered these places and then built on them, and these plants were destroyed. She used gouache, which is a type of opaque watercolour, to do her paintings. It's quite thick gouaches, it's a bit sticky, and you kind of you use it in a slightly different way to how you would use normal watercolour. You often have to use quite a stiff kind of tool to put it on. You don't necessarily always use a normal paintbrush for it. Her work has been compared to some of the masters at painting from nature. So she did a great job. She was very, very good. Now I want us to watch a little video clip, and we're just going to watch this video and kind of imagine that we're in the world of Margaret Mee. And this is the discovery of the moonflower.
Thank you. A Amazônia, acho que sempre teve um quê de mistério muito grande. A Amazônia é a maior floresta do mundo. A grande diferença na maioria das pessoas é que ela agiu quando teve oportunidade. Tem muita gente que tem sonhos e que não realizam porque falta a aventura, né?
Ela sabia o que é um desenvolver artístico, o que é chegar num estilo, o que é ser você dentro da arte. Isso ela fez, e ela conseguiu fazer, e as pinturas da Margaret são completamente diferentes das pinturas botânicas. Parece que ela entra dentro da planta, assim como eu acho que ela está dentro dessa floresta.
E aí eu todo dia ia com ela na canoa, tirar aquelas plantas. Aí eu disse pra ela, dona Margarete, vamos embora. A senhora não quer que a gente durma aqui no porto da senhora? Ela disse assim, não, vá dormir na sua casa, pode deixar comigo que eu já dormi até com as onças. Ela era corajosa.
I had to climb onto the top of the boat, and with all my sketching materials and that, and sit there in front of the bud, waiting for it to open. It moved as it opened. You could see it opening. This was thrilling. And as it opened, a wonderful perfume came out. To attract the moth, of course, which is, it's a hawk moth which pollinates it. There was a full moon looking through the branches of the tree, magnificent, and all the time the sound of the night bird.
Ela tinha um amor mesmo, uma paixão e um comprometimento em registrar essas espécies, em buscar tudo que tinha de mais lindo dentro dessas florestas. O interesse dela era justamente preservar e levar esse conhecimento e essa experiência dela aos outros.
Isn't that just amazing? Margaret Mee was commissioned to illustrate something called the Flora Basilica. This was a really, really ambitious project to catalogue, that means to pull together all the illustrations of the plants of the whole of Brazil. This involved working expeditions to various parts of Brazil, and she'd get in a boat and she'd sail to all these places and then she would collate all her paintings, and she was asked to put it all together in one big catalogue. Now this is the original publication, and it's about her life and her works, and it was published in 1988, which again isn't all that long ago. I guess it is that long ago, but maybe I was about 7 when it was published. It was published just days before she sadly died in a car accident. I just think that's such a tragic story, that all of her work and her life's work that led up to putting all of her paintings into this amazing catalogue, into this amazing book, and she got to see it published, and then she died really suddenly in a car accident. So today, We're going to have a bit of a look at some of Margaret Mee's paintings. I'll show you a few examples now. And what I want us to do is we're going to have a look at this one. This is called the Tebuia Umbellata. Okay, now this is by Margaret Mee, and she used gouache to paint this. So there's a picture of the real plant and the flowers, and there's Margaret Mee's depiction of it. And you can see those really fine details, just like Sir Joseph Banks had in his, the little parts of the plant. We're going to use this picture, and then we're going to compare it with a piece of art by Sir Joseph Banks. So this is quite an artistic skill to have. Last week we did some critique, and today we're going to use some of those critique skills, but we're going to bring them together in a comparison of a piece of art by Margaret Mee and a piece of art by Sir Joseph Banks. So this is the one by Margaret Mee, and then this one is by Sir Joseph Banks. You can see the real plant, then you can see his depiction of it. And Sir Joseph Banks used pencil initially, then probably engraved it to print it, and then added the watercolour. So it's two different techniques as well, two different ways, hundreds of years between the two illustrations. But we're going to compare the two. Now, just as we had last week, I want to just remind us of these four concepts that are really important when we're critiquing or comparing art in any way. We're going to describe, we're going to analyse, we're going to interpret, and then this time we're going to compare. What I want you to do is on your sheet next to the pictures that you've got, this is going to be a fluid piece of work where you're going to talk to me, basically write to me about the comparison of the two pieces of art. So we're going to you're going to start by describing. What can you see in each piece of art? A few sentences about Margaret Mee's, a few sentences about Sir Joseph Banks. Can you identify the media that has been used by each artist? We know that. We know what it was. Go back and have a look if you've forgotten. Can you identify the genre? Is it portrait? Is it in landscape? Is it abstract? Is it still life? Can you describe everything that you can see, even if you can't explain it? Then I want you to analyse each piece. How are the lines, shapes, colours, tones and textures used in each piece of art? How does each artist capture the proportions, and are the paintings to scale? So when you're doing this comparison, I want you to be thinking about the way that you switch backwards and forwards to talking about both pieces of art about the same amount. It's almost like a discussion that you're going to go backwards and forwards. Margaret Mee did it like this. Sir Joseph Banks does it like this. They're quite similar in the way they did this and the way that they present this, that kind of thing. Then I want you to interpret it. Is the purpose of the artwork the same or different? If it's the same, just say it's the same. If it's different, tell me why. And that's the purpose of the art, why that art was done. And then, this is a bit meatier at the end here, this comparison. What is similar about the way the two artists approach their botanical illustrations? What's similar and what's different? Those two words, similar and different, they've been running through your whole school life, I should imagine. And now it's going to come together. What's similar? What's different? Do they use the same media? Do they present them in the same way? Are they using the same paint? Are they using different media? Which piece looks the most realistic? And you can see that because you've got a photograph of each one and you've got their depiction of it. Can you see the difference in when the art was produced? Can you tell that one was done hundreds of years before the other one? Are there any differences in the way the artists record detail? And which one do you like the best and why? So I'm going to leave you to it. This comparison should take you a good few minutes. You might even want to put on some really nice calm music and enjoy the fact that you can be really studying these amazing pieces of art, and then you can be surrounded by music as well. And it's a really calming, lovely thing to do. It'll be really good for our well-being as well. And I can't wait to hear the comparisons that you come up with. I can't wait to read them, and I can't wait to read which one you like the best. I can't decide which one I like the best. But I wonder if you can. I wonder if you like one more than the other. So I'll leave you to it, and I'll see you next time.